In this video, I am going to explain structure of upper cervical spines. I will talk about this region. I will talk about occiput, C1 and C2. This is occiput. This is C1. It is also known as atlas. This is C2, also known as axis. Why is this atlas? This name is from Greek mythology. In Greek mythology, atlas is bearing heaven. So, in anatomy, C1 looks like it is bearing occiput, head, right? That is why C1 is called atlas, like Greek mythology god. Then why is C2 called axis? Because this is literally axis. I will talk about its anatomy for another picture later. Let me talk about joint between occiput and atlas. The structure of C1 looks like atlas from Greek mythology. It's like here. This is concave surface. This concave surface is superior articular facet. Superior articular facet. Facet is a joint among cervical spines, like here. Here, this is facet joint. This is superior articular facet. And this part of occiput is occipital condyle. Occipital condyle. Condyle means bony bump. Okay? Superior articular facet is concave surface. Occipital condyle is convex surface. So occiput is sitting on atlas. Again, that's why it looks like Greek mythology. Atlas is bearing heaven. This C1 is bearing head. That makes sense. Then name of this joint is atlanto-occipital joint. Atlanto-occipital joint, also known as AO joint. Because of this concave-convex surface, favorite movement of AO joint is flexion and extension of head. Like here, this is concave surface, and this is convex surface. So occiput kind of glides on concave surface. So movement is flexion and extension. Does it make sense? Now let me talk about joint structure between C1 and C2. Okay, this is superior view. This is C1. Okay, this is atlas. This part is superior articular facet, the concave surface. Okay, of course, beneath C1, there is C2. Then I want you to focus on one structure. That's here. This is part of C2 that is facing to this part of C1. Blue part is C2. Yellow part is C1. This part is called dense. Dense means tooth. So dense is like a tooth, the prominent of C2. Do you remember the other name of C2? That is axis. So dense is acting like axis. On the C2, C1 can do rotational movement. Dense, this is part of C2. Around dense, C1 can rotate. The joint between C1 and C2 is called atlantoaxial joint. Atlantoaxial joint. Let's look at its joint from different picture. This is profile view. This is C2 axis. This is C1 atlas. You don't see dents on this picture. Imagine dents is like this, the bony prominent of C2. Then this part is axis of atlantoaxial joint. So this is axis. Along this axis, C1 can rotate. So favorite movement of atlantoaxial joint is, of course, rotation. AO joint, AA joint movement are very unique. Other joints also can do flexion, extension, and rotation, but occiput C1 and C1 C2 joint are very unique compared to other parts of cervical spines. Let's go back to superior view. Okay, this is C1 and C2. This is dense. Then I want to talk about one ligament. There is ligament that is close to dense. This purple one is ligament. This is transverse ligament. Transverse ligament. This ligament holds adequate position of dents. Let's say if somebody's transverse ligament is torn, maybe dents will be out of position or C1 goes wrong position. Then in such a case, can you do rotation? Maybe not. Thus, this transverse ligament is very important for cervical rotation. Let's add a ligament on this picture. Again, this is dense. Transverse ligament is here. So this is like a supporter of dense and C1. If this ligament is torn, dense can be out of place, or C1 can be out of place. Along this dense, C1 can rotate. This is very important place. Then I'm going to talk about important myofascial connection. This is connective tissue. This connective tissue connects C1 and occiput. Remember, this is C1, this is not C2. This pink one is posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. Posterior atlanto-occipital membrane that connects occiput and C1. Then there is important tiny muscle around this membrane. It's like here, it's very close to this membrane. This blue one represents rectus capitis posterior minor. Posterior minor. This is part of suboccipital muscles. Again, this blue one represents rectus capitis posterior minor. This muscle is very close to this membrane. Why does it matter? Okay, posterior atlanto-occipital membrane is close to membrane around spinal cord. Imagine this purple one is membrane, that is dura mater. Dura mater covers brain and spinal cord. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. This is posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. They are close to dura mater of spinal cord. So if your neck muscle gets tight, this tightness can go to inside part of spine. Thus, that can tighten up membrane around spinal cord. This membrane can go up to brain, or that can go to peripheral nervous system. So this area is freaking important. Let me review today's material. This is occiput. This is C1, also known as atlas. This is C2. Occiput is sitting on C1. This part is concave surface. This is convex surface. It looks like atlas is supporting occiput. That is why C1 is called atlas. That is from Greek mythology. Okay? C2 is also known as axis. Part of axis is called dens, this bony prominent. Along this bony prominent, C1 can rotate. Okay, then, by the way, favorite movement of occiput and C1 is flexion extension. C1, C2 is rotation. This area is very unique compared to other cervical spines. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy of upper cervical spines. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.